And for those of you that have not been paying attention to the news of the day, and I don't want to get political, and I don't want to bring us all down as it pertains to just politics and business as it's related to our hometown that we love so much, Buffalo, New York. But the reality is that some stuff is going on, and the stuff is this. So New Era Company, New Era Corporation, which they own the naming rights to our stadium, to the Bill Stadium, they have requested and have received permission to break their contract with Erie County and the Buffalo Bills to basically remove the naming rights, New Era Field, from basically the stadium. So we are at this point in time, we're not homeless as a team, but we are in a situation where we are nameless, if you will. And for me, there's a lot that goes into this, and there's a lot of fan reaction going on. And, you know, I don't necessarily have questions, and I don't know that there's questions that could necessarily be asked, but my first gut feeling literally goes back to, I don't know what's going on with New Era. New Era has gone through some layoffs. They completely closed the Derby plant. For those of you that don't know, New Era is from Buffalo. They're a Buffalo-based organization and company. They closed their Derby plant, and they just announced another 117 layoffs, which prompted the Erie County Commissioner to come out and basically slam them publicly, which made national news. Advance 1 week, basically, and they're now saying, you know what? We're out. Right? And I don't know that... Maybe it's a money situation, but is it a money situation, or is it a situation where they're like, you know what? Thanks, but no thanks. Like, that's not the press we need. So I don't know what the answer is. When did you hear about it? What time was it today that you read that news? Dude, I was in shock when I read that.
I was too. And actually, I heard about it like right when I jumped in the chat because I was at work. So, I'm shocked, man. It's like, I get it, though. I understand New Era's financial situation, so I get that. But the way the press release came out, it actually, it just looks like there's some underlying things there as well. I just think that there's more than just the financial aspect. I don't know. I don't know, man. What do you think we're going to name it?
So there's a lot of there's a lot of prospects. I mean, there's great companies out there, and I think it's going to be different this time. So, you know, there was a great deal of, I remember when Ralph Wilson was still the owner, and, you know, and I don't know how much you guys would remember or you, J. Spence, would remember, but there was a, you know, I think Ralph Wilson came out at one point in time, and it was right when he named the stadium Ralph Wilson Stadium, which was great. It's a legacy thing, but that's money that he's giving up. The Bills, if anybody remembers, and a lot of people don't know this, the Buffalo Bills, when the stadium was named Rich Stadium, we were one of the very first teams in the NFL to sell the naming rights to our stadium. And all of that money goes back to the owner. And then it came out that Ralph Wilson said that, you know, well, there's just not really enough money in it and blah, 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 blah. And the reality was there wasn't, but it wasn't because of the Buffalo market. It was because the Bills sucked. That was why there wasn't money in naming that stadium, anything else, or somebody paying for it. We have another super chat from Steve Mathis, super sticker. I don't know what that means,
the
bro.
The judge.
What does that mean, judge, man? Super sticker. I don't know what super sticker means, but I appreciate the super chat. So anyways, so getting back to it. So for me now I thought the New Era, Matt Parrino came out and said, who would be the perfect fit for the naming rights to the stadium? And I'm like, bro, New Era was the perfect fit. They're a hometown team, national, worldwide known brand, hometown team. It's like, you've got to be kidding me right now. Like, this is the marriage that you want. This is where it's at. However, the Bills have a budding young star at quarterback. We both agree with that. Yes, I know a second ago I was talking about how it might not go the way that we think it should, but Josh Allen is a budding young star. They're a playoff team. They're a team on the rise. They're being like, people are picking them, even with Cam, people are picking them to go to the playoffs and to win the East. They're on primetime television 4 to 5 times this year already. Like that, the name of that stadium is going to be talked about often in the national media. So if I'm of the opinion you asked who it was, I don't necessarily know. There's obviously big corporations out there like Amazon. And what's funny is I saw a lot of hate, like, for people that were like, what if it's Amazon? And there's, you know, Jeff Bezos isn't exactly a big fan amongst a lot of Americans because he has so much money. But Amazon, I mean, there's a lot of corporations out there. But know this, literally, the Pagulas are going to cash in. Like, whoever it is, they're going to pay some big money. Who do you think? What names are out? Verizon's taken. AT&T is taken. I mean, what else? I don't know if there's anything in town, right? I mean, it's not going to be Delaware North Stadium. That doesn't, I mean, what's his name? Jeremy Jacobs is a billionaire, but it's not going to be Delaware North.
Pray State. To God it's not Delaware North State. Pray to God, man. I don't know. I know this won't happen, but I would like to see them kind of take the approach that that our previous owner took, and not necessarily name it the Pagulas or anything like that, but like the one Buffalo theme. I think I would like to see that. I know a lot of Sabres fans got ticked off when I posted that. So, you know, I'm sure a lot of Sabres fans wouldn't necessarily appreciate that, but, and I don't think it's going to happen anyway. So, but we'll see. I see a lot of people saying Bills Mafia Stadium. I don't think that'll happen. It looks like the Pagulas, they don't even really acknowledge us saying Bills Mafia all the time. Like every once in a while, it might slip out and they have to catch themselves, but they really don't. They don't push the Bills Mafia name like we would like them to. We can't even get the hashtag on Twitter.
Right. I think what's funny too is like, so the people that, and I love hometown. So hometown organizations, for those of you that don't know, Kodak, Rochester, IBM is in Rochester. And those corporations, IBM not so much, but Kodak is a shell of its former self. I don't think that Kodak is going to have the money to pony up. As far
IBM,
as,
I could see.
IBM possibly, but IBM is not the company that IBM was. It'll be interesting to see. I mean, the corporations that we're used to, like being huge, ginormous corporations, aren't what they were. When you think about General Electric, right? GE, like in places, it's now the billion-dollar companies are Twitter and Facebook and like weird, like, are we talking Facebook Stadium? Are we talking Twitter Stadium? Are we talking, you know, Instagram Stadium? I mean, it'll be interesting to kind of see what happens from that.